हेलो, आई डॉक्टर अमृता कुमारी, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर इन डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ जूलॉजी, हिंदू गर्ल्स कॉलेज, सोनीपत। दिस लेक्चर इज़ बीइंग रिकॉर्डेड फॉर ई कंटेंट डेवलपमेंट प्रोग्राम अंडर डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ हायर एजुकेशन, हरियाणा, फॉर अंडर ग्रेजुएट पीएससी क्लासेस। इन दिस टॉपिक आई विल डील विद द इम्पॉर्टेंट रोडेंट्स एंड बर्ड्स पेस्ट ऑफ एग्रीकल्चर एंड देयर मैनेजमेंट, which is included in the BSc 6th SAM syllabus. So first of all, we have to know that what are rodents. So rodents are the mammals of order Rodentia, which are characterized by a single pair of incisors in each of upper and lower jaws. These are as old pests as is the human civilization. Order Rodentia, it includes about 351 genera. Out of that, 45 genera belonging to four families are present in India, and among these 45 genera, 11 species causes significant damage to crops in India. So one by one we will deal with all these 11 species in detail. So first species is Rattus meltada. It is soft-furred field rat. It is found in all over India. The color of this rat is dark brown dorsally and grayish white ventrally. Head length is 8.3 cm, body length is 15.6 cm, and tail length is 13.2 cm. This species of rat, it is nocturnal, means it is active during night. The fur of this rat is small in size and is spineless. The main damage caused by this rat species is to the succulent plants, grains and stems. Next rodent species is Mus buduga. Its common name is Indian field mouse. In India, it is mainly present in states like UP, Bihar, Haryana and Punjab. The color of this rat is grayish ventrally and brown dorsally. Head length is 4 to 5 cm. Body length is 8 to 9 cm and tail length is 6 to 7.5 cm. This is rat species is also nocturnal, means active during night, and feeds on crops like sugarcane, maize, paddy, etc. Next species is Rattus rattus, that is house rat. It is commonly found rodent in India. The color of this rat is reddish brown dorsally and grayish white ventrally. Head and body length is 11.5 to 21 cm and tail length is 12 to 20 cm. This species of rat is again nocturnal and is found in warehouses, houses, fields and seaports. Next rodent species is Rattus norvegicus. It is Norway rat. This rat is not the native of India but found in all big towns. Color of this rat is dark brown dorsally and grayish ventrally. Length of head, body and tail is 20 to 25 cm. This species is also again nocturnal and is found in sewers. The main damage caused by this rat species is to the stored grains. Next rodent species is Mus musculus, that is house mouse. It is distributed in all over India. The color of this rodent species is brown dorsally and grayish white ventrally. Head length is 2 to 5 cm. Body length is 3 to 7 cm and tail length is 4 to 11 cm. This species of rat is also nocturnal. Beside this, it is an omnivorous pest which is found in houses, godowns, hostels and poultry farms. Next rodent species is Mus platythrix. Its common name is brown swiney mouse. It is distributed in India in states like Punjab, Haryana, UP, MP, Bihar and West Bengal. Color of this rodent species is paler brown dorsally and white ventrally. This species of rat is also nocturnal and is found in dry fields and banks of ponds. Next is Golunda ilioti. Its common name is Indian bush rat. This species of rodent is present in states like Punjab, Haryana and Rajasthan in India. Color of this species is yellowish brown dorsally and grayish ventrally. Length of head and body is 9 to 17 cm and tail length is 7 to 12 cm. This species of rat is found in thick bushes, sugarcane fields and fodder crops. Next species of rodent is Bandicoota bengalensis. Its common name is Indian mole rat. It is found in India in all states except Rajasthan. Color of this rodent species is dark brown dorsally and grayish white ventrally. Head and body length is 12 to 25 cm. Tail length is 10 to 21 cm. Beside this, the tail bears prominent rings on it. It is again nocturnal pest which is found in crop fields and godowns. Next species is Bandicoota indica. Its common name is large bandicoot rat. It is found in states like Punjab, Haryana, UP and Bihar. The size of this rat is larger than Indian mole rat. Head and body length is 22 to 36 cm. Tail length of this rat is 17 to 35 cm. Bandicoot indica. This species is again nocturnal and it's an omnivore and fossorial pest which is found in houses, schools and big buildings. Next rodent species is Hystrix indica. Its common name is Indian crested porcupine. It is a native of state like Kashmir, Himachal Pradesh, hilly areas of UP and Nepal. It is a large rodent which is having a well-developed quills on its whole back. This species is again nocturnal and causes heavy damage to vegetables, crops like onions and potatoes. Last rodent species is Phonambulus pinnanthi. Its common name is five-striped plum squirrel. It is found in states like Punjab, Haryana, UP, Himachal Pradesh, Jammu Kashmir, Gujarat and Maharashtra. Body of this squirrel is grayish brown dorsally with five white strips separated by brown bands. The color on the ventral side is grayish white. It is an arboreal pest, that is, it is living on the trees and is diurnal. This species, it causes great damage to vegetables, fruits and crops. Now in this table, we will deal with the crops and their extent of damage or loss caused by various rodent pest species. So first one is the rice crop. The extent of loss due to rodent pest species is 1.1 to 44.5% due to rodent pest species that are Bandicoota bengalensis, Melardia meltada, Muspiduca radus, nititis. Next is wheat crop. The extent of damage to this crop is 2.7 to 21.3% by rodent pest species that are Bandicoota bengalensis, Melardia meltada, Tetra indica and Meriones horinae. Next crop is sugarcane crop. The extent of loss to this crop is 2.1 to 31% by rodent pest species that are Bandicoota bengalensis, Nesokia indica and Melardia meltada. Next crop is groundnut crop. The extent of loss due to rodent pests, it is 2.9 to 7.3% due to rodent pest species that are Tetra indica, Melardia meltada and Bandicoota bengalensis. Vegetables, they are also damaged by this rodent pest species, and the extent of loss due to this rodent pest, it is 1.4 to 30.6% due to Bendicota bengalensis, Millardia melitata, Tetra indica, Marion's horinae, and Funambula spinenti. Again, the fruits, they are also damaged by this rodent pest, but the extent of loss is greatly varied in the fruits, and the main pest of this fruit, it is Funambula spinenti and Funambula palmarum, and last are the stored grains that are damaged up to 2.5% by the rodent species that are Rattus rattus and Mus musculus. Next, we have to deal with the control and management of these rodents. So, how we can manage and control these rodents? There are various methods of control that includes mechanical control method, under which we can use various types of traps and ultrasonic waves. Next method of control is the biological control, in which we can use various predator birds and parasitic viruses. And last is the chemical control, in which we can use various types of attractants, repellents, killers, chemosterilants, or fumigants to control or manage these rodent pest species. So one by one, we will deal with all these types of control methods. First one is the mechanical control, in which we can use various type of traps like wire gauze trap, cable tie trap, and bamboo trap to trap these rodents. Next, under the biological control, we can use this predator birds like kite, owl, hawk, cat, and snake to control this rodent pests, or we can use various parasitic viruses like Salmonella typhimurium and Salmonella enteritis to control this rodent pests. And next one is the chemical control. So under chemical control, we can use various type of chemicals that may be solid, liquid, or gas that are used to kill the rodents. So we can call these chemicals which are used to kill the rodents are called rodenticides. So the use of this rodenticide, we know that it is very common and effective method of controlling rodent population. So various type of rodenticides that are used at present, they are attractants, repellents, killers, chemosterilants, and fumigants. So one by one, we will deal with all these rodenticides. First one is the attractants. So what are attractants? Attractants are used to attract rodents towards trap or towards a trap to kill them mechanically. Example of the attractants are extracts of kevada, lemon, ghee, etc. They are all used as attractants to attract these rodents and kill them mechanically. Next are the repellents. So repellents, what are repellents? These are substances which keep rodents away temporarily. And the most commonly used repellents are endrin, melathion, and cyclohexamide. Next are the killers. So what are killers? These are the chemicals that are used to kill the rodents, and these include acute poisons and anticoagulants. So acute poisons, these further include zinc phosphide and red squill. Zinc phosphide, it kills rodents by releasing phosphine in stomach of the rodent pest, causing injury to kidneys, liver, and lungs of the rodents. Red squill, it is one of the oldest rodenticide, and it is safe for non-target species, which is commonly called silmurine. Next category of killers, they are anticoagulants. So what are anticoagulants? These are the chemicals which prevent coagulation of blood in case of internal bleeding and external bleeding. These include fumarin, warfarin and calciferol. So this fumarin, the effect of this fumarin, it varies from 5 to 20 days and it is effective against species like Rattus rattus, Rattus norvegicus and Mus musculus. Next anticoagulant is warfarin. It is effective within 6 to 14 days and it is a wide spectrum rodenticide, means it can be used for a wide range of rodent pests. And next is the calciferol. Calciferol, it can be used alone or may be used in the combination with warfarin, and effect it occurs in 7 days. Next category of chemical control is the chemosterolants. So what are chemosterolants? These are the chemicals which prevent development of gonads in developing rodents. Example of these chemosterolants are furadentin and colchicin that causes sterility in male and female of Bandicoota bengalensis. Other chemosterolants examples are olidone, uracil and inovid. Next are fumigants. So what are fumigants? These are the chemicals which at normal temperature exist in a gaseous state in sufficient concentration to be lethal to the organisms. Example of fumigants are hydrogen cyanide. So this hydrogen cyanide, it is evolved from calcium cyanide and is blown in the rodent burrows directly, and it is very toxic to the human beings, so it is used in the vacant areas. Next fumigant is carbon tetrachloride. It is very quick acting fumigant which kills rats in their burrows. And ethylene dimeromide, it is again a very highly toxic fumigant which should be used in the field but never in the houses. So now the question arises, how we can use these rodenticides? So for using this rodenticides, first of all, we have the knowledge about the burrows. So the first point to be considered while using this rodenticide is to survey the burrow, where their burrows, alive burrows, they are present. Next is the pre-baiting. Pre-baiting means we have the knowledge about the preferred food of that particular rodent species. And last is the preparation of poison baits. So baits, they are formed by use of the rodenticide and the preferred food of the rodents in a particular proportion. For example, bait of red squill is formed by having one part of red squill and 9 parts of the preferred food of that rodent that is mixed with the water. So next are the precautions for the use of a bait. So what precautions we have to take while using a particular bait? First is that it should be done in clear weather. It should be applied at places away from the reach of children because they are very toxic. Next precaution is the operation of baiting. It should be repeated till rodents are killed. Next precaution is that baits should be kept well inside the burrow. And last is that after handling of these poisonous baits, the hands, they should be washed properly. So after the rodent pests, we will deal with this pestiferous birds. Now what are pestiferous birds? These are the birds that causes damage to crops, oil seeds, vegetables and fruits. So the main pestiferous birds, these includes house sparrow, that is Passer domesticus, house crow, that is Corvus splendens, common mynah, that is Acridotherus tristis, pigeon, that is Columba olivia, baya weaver, that is Plosius philippinus, rose-ringed parakeet, that is Cetacula crameri, and red-vented bulbul, that is Cycnonotus gaffer. So one by one we will deal in detail these all pestiferous birds. We also know that birds, they also causes a great loss to our crops by different methods like feeding on grains, fruits and sown seed, or by pulling up seedlings or by trampling seedlings. The birds, they can also break branches when roosting. They can also foul nursery stalks and lawns. Birds, they can also cause damage to irrigation pipes, and they can also serve as vectors of plant pathogens like bacteria. So one by one we will deal with all these pestiferous birds in detail. First one is the house crow, that is Corvus splendens. Is commonly called Kowa or Kaga. It is an omnivorous bird which feeds on grains, fruits, eggs, insects and kitchen refuses. The adult bird length is 30 to 45 centimeter. Body of this house crow, it is covered with black feathers on dorsal side and grayish colored is present on its neck and breast area. Next pestiferous bird is common weaver bird, that is Plosia philippinus. It is very common in North Indian states, especially near river and ponds. It is a very small bird with length of 10 to 12 centimeter. Color of this bird is grayish white with yellowish neck. It is a herbivorous bird and causes a great damage to cereal crops. Next pestiferous bird is house sparrow, that is Passer domesticus. It is cosmopolitan in distribution. It is a very small bird with a length of 9 to 15 centimeter. Female bird is grayish white in color, while males are light brown in color. It is an omnivorous bird, but mainly granivorous, means it mainly feeds on the food grains, so it causes damage to the food grains. Next pestiferous bird is common manna. Its scientific name is Acridotherus tristis. It is commonly found in North Indian states. The color of this common manna is dark brown on dorsal side and pale on ventral side. Sexual dimorphism is absent in this bird, means male and female, they are not identified. Length of the adult bird is 20 to 35 centimeter, and this common manna, it causes main damage to seeds and fruits. Next species is rose-ringed parakeet. Its scientific name is Sitacula crameri. Adult bird length is 30 to 45 centimeter. The color of this parakeet is green color plumage with rose colored collar around its neck. It has very short, sharp edged and stout beak. It is a gregarious and very noisy bird which feeds on grains, vegetables and fruits. Next pestiferous bird is blue rock pigeon. Its scientific name is Columba livia. It is distributed throughout India. The body of this bird is spindle shape and the length of adult is 30 to 35 centimeter. Color of this bird is gray with metallic green on upper breast and neck area. It is an omnivorous bird which feeds on grains, pulses, fruits and seeds of fruits. Now here we will deal with the nature and extent of the damage that is caused by these pestiferous birds. There are some studies done by various scientists across the India about the nature and extent of damage caused by these pestiferous birds. For example, mustard crop is damaged up to 63% by parakeets at the stage of ripening, according to Simwat and Sindhu. Pulses, they are also damaged by doves, pigeons, parakeets and sparrow up to 66% according to Mehrotra and Bhatnagar. Crows, they can cause damage to wheat crop at the time of sprouting up to 17 to 20% according to Chahal et al. Parakeets, they damage guava fruits at the time of their ripening up to 20% according to Singh and Kumar. Peach fruit yield is greatly reduced up to 32% by parakeets and crows according to Tour and Sandhu. So now in this section we will deal with the management of pestiferous birds, how we can manage these pestiferous birds. The first point is that we have the knowledge of damage causing species, in which we have the knowledge about its habit and habitat. Next is that we have to estimate the extent of damage caused by the particular pestiferous bird. Next point to be considered for the management of this pestiferous bird is to estimate the effect of control program of this pest. Next point that is to be considered is the cost benefit ratio of the particular control program we are applying in our field to control these pestiferous birds. And last is the effect of that control program on the ecological balance. Now, the bird control techniques, how we can control these birds, pestiferous birds. First is the man-operated traps, in which we can use various types of nets to capture these birds, or we can use straw baskets, wooden rods and long ropes, or we can also use recordings of birds and birds' calls and notes. We can also control these pestiferous birds by using automatic traps like potter trap and house trap, or we can also go for various types of scaring techniques that are very commonly used by farmers in their fields, like use of the cross scare, drumming, platform, hanging dead bird, shouting and using gulail, hawk kite, balloons, fireworks and using CDs. So these are various scaring techniques that are used by the farmers to control these pestiferous birds. So last is the chemical control of these pestiferous birds. So for this we can go for various type of repellents or secondary poisons. In the repellents we can use thyrum, chlorpyrifos and nimbacidine. They are used at the stage of seed germination and sprouting. The seeds, they are immersed in the solution of these repellents. Next is the secondary poison, in which we can use zinc phosphide, which kills the rodents. By this, omnivorous birds that feed on the rodents, they are killed. So after viewing this video, there are some certain important questions that I am discussing here, like name two pestiferous birds, name three rodent pests. Next question is, what is the use of ultrasonic waves in the rodent control? Next question is, name two types of stomach poison. Next question is, define rodenticides. Next is, what is the scientific name of red-vented bulbul? Next question is, what is the scientific name of Indian mole rat? Next question is, what is debarking? Next is, what are mechanical traps? Next important question is, define fumigants. Which fumigants are used to control rodents? Next important question is, describe various methods of control of pestiferous birds. Next question is, write in detail about various control methods of rodent pests. And last important question is, write about various types of insecticides on the basis of their mode of entry.